The four-man Fishin' Tackle Choir.
Everybody gather round
as the harmonies abound, and your heart begins to pound when you hear that quartet sound. Hear that! Bushman, I'm the leader of the choir. Although there's only four of us, that's all that we require. We sing at wakes and weddings and at every swell affair. And when your spirit needs a song, you know that we'll be there. Now Tracy moans a baritone and makes it sweet and clear.
And when the place fills up with bass, you know that Neil is here.
And Mark the tenor sings higher and higher and sets the sound afire. Songs you love, the foreman of the Fish and Tackle Choir.
Singing a song.
Come on along.
To make you smile.
A happy smile.
Losing your cares.
Goodbye,
cares. For just a while.
For just a while.
We're hooked on harmony.
We never tire. Oh, we're the foreman of the Fish and Tackle Choir.
Pick up your spirits and follow along.
We'll carry your troubles away with a song.
If you will call us, we're always for hire.
CD's available after the show.
Songs you love, the foreman of the Fish and Tackle Choir.
Songs you love, the foreman of the Fish and Tackle Choir.
Oh!
I'm walking on air, the why and the wherefore is something I care for. Hear me shout it, I'm yelling, I'm telling folks everywhere, I got me a trophy. So what do I care, what do I care? There's a rainbow around my shoulder and a sky of the sun shines bright and I'm all right doing what I love. There's a rainbow around my shoulder and it makes me want to shout. And I'll sing out loud because I'm so proud of this
big
honking trout.
Hallelujah, how the folks will stare when they see it hanging over there. Wall between
the 16-point buck and the grizzly bear. There's a rainbow around my shoulder, and he's plenty good. He's good enough.
And I'm
shouting so the world will know. He'll look good stuffed. How the folks will stop and stare at that fish up there. On the looking at that, I'm in my rocking chair, sweet rocking chair. There's a rainbow around my shoulder, and it makes me want to shout
right out. And a mountain it's all,
yes,
so the world will know.
Let them know that there's a rainbow around my shoulder, a rainbow trout, a rainbow, and there'll be no doubt.
I call that bait. Well, we're from the north of Michigan, but we're up at the northern end of the mitt of Michigan, and on up across the bridge there, in Michigan's upper peninsula, what we call the UP, that's where the folks really know how to live right, life right, eh? So I'm going to tell you about a couple of friends I got up there. You know, there's Ole and Lena, and there's one night, they've been married now a long time, and there's one night that Lena wakes up and Ole ain't there beside her, and she wonders where he is. And so she goes down and looking around, sure enough, she finds him sitting at the kitchen table. And when he looks up, she can see he's been crying. She says, "Ole, what's wrong?" He says, "Well, I was just thinking about the old times." And she said, "Well, what's got you feeling bad?" He said, "Well, do you remember that time when we was dating and there was that one night that we stayed out pretty late and I brought you home and I parked the truck there in the driveway and, well, you remember things kind of got out of hand and the next thing you know, your pa comes out and yanks the truck door open and then he dragged me out and told me if I didn't marry you right away, he'd see that I went to jail for 20 years. Do you remember that?" And she said, "Well, yeah, I remember that, but why are you so sad?" He said, "Well, I was just thinking I could have been out tomorrow."
Oh, when I was a kid without a care in the world, never thought of fancy cars or money or girls. I'd go fishing with my buddies down at the brook, just to stick a willow piece, a line, and a hook. Find some fish and worms beneath a rod and a log, just sitting with my buddies and my old yellow dog. First we started fishing and we really did try. Then the day got hotter with a sunless sky. Took off all our shirts and put our feet in the brook. But the sun kept rising, really started to cook. Only one thing left to do to keep ourselves cool.
It didn't take us long till we were in the nude. In the nude, oh yeah, just right for swimming. In the nude, oh no, there weren't no women. In the nude, oh yeah, it's just the best way to make a kid so happy on a sunny, hot day. Swinging on a rope, swing your cares away. When you were just a kid and in the nude and swimming. Up there behind me. cast a fly and catch a rainbow. Why, oh, why can't I? Why can't I?
Well, you know, back in the days when Ole and Lena was dating, there finally come the time when Lena's mother came to visit, and Ole took him in the truck out to see his little farm. He's pretty proud of his farm, but you know, he never soon got into that driveway, and the mother-in-law, future mother-in-law, starts saying, "Oh, look at this barn. That thing's fallen down. It needs to be fixed. It needs to be painted. Your house looks awful. And look at this livestock you got around here. Them chickens are missing half their feathers. Them cows look all bony. And look at that mule. That is the ugliest, scroungiest mule I ever seen." Well, a mule takes umbrage, apparently, kicks her in the side of the head, and she dies right there. Now, that ain't a joke. And sure enough, so they have the funeral, you know. And after the funeral, you know, all the folks are going out, and by the steps is the pastor, and there's Ole and Lena, and as the folks walk by, you know, everybody says a few soft words to Ole, and all the ladies, when they say some words to Ole, he nods his head. And all the men folk, when they go by, Ole, he listens, and then he shakes his head. And the pastor notices this, and he says, "Now, after everybody's gone," he said, "Ole, tell me how come it was that when I see the ladies talk to you, you're nodding your head, and when the men folk talk to you, you're shaking your head?" And he says, "What's going on?" We said, "Well, when the ladies come by, they say, wasn't that a shame?" And I say, "Oh, yes, it was a terrible shame." "And when the men folk come by, they say, you want to sell that mule?"
Let's stop sitting, no more wishing.
Let's go fishing with my buddies today.
If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go down by the creek? Fishing with a stick, with a stick. Just like you did long ago, straw hat, no shoes, taking a stroll down by the creek. Fishing with a stick. A willow stick, some line, and one old fish hook. Trying hard to get some dishes to cook. Take a good look, get some bait, and all the fellas just can't wait, and we can tell we'll get some fish. Fishing with a stick. We were sitting, we were wishing, brook trout fishing on the creek. That was many years ago. We still fish, but don't you know, now we fish the modern way. Get our limit every day. Fast boats and fancy gear, good friends and lots of cheer. Good spin every dime for a wonderful time. So if you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where life's a kick? Fishing with a stick, with a stick. Get your gear and waterproof clothes, lots of beer, and everyone knows we'll catch fish. Fishing with a stick. Dressed up like a $1 million angler. We don't need no lures or wormy danglers. That's for amateurs on the lake, and all the fellas just can't wait, and we can tell we'll get a hit. Fishing with a stick, fishing with a stick, yeah. Fishing with a stick, yeah. Fishing with a stick.
Now we're fishing, no more wishing. We don't miss 'em
'cause we're doing it.
Fishing with a stick.
Stick of dynamite.
That's how you do it.
Hey, fellas.
Did you do it?
Hey, fellas, remember what I told you I was saving up for?
Yeah?
Yeah. Said. Today was the day.
Ah, yeah. Great.
Saved up all my hard-earned dough. I just know I gotta go buy my bass boat. It's a beauty, 18 feet sparkling green, fast and sleek. That's my bass boat. 60 miles an hour on the water. You know I'm so happy that I bought her. Hitch the trailer and the lights at the lake late tonight, bass boat. And bass boat fishing in the dead of night. Take these brand new lures and let them fly all my life.
I have just been waiting for this moment to arrive. Bass boat fishing in the dead of night.
Ain't no moon tonight, so I can't see. That's all right.
GPS and sonar, I can get back with some speed.
Bass boat fly,
oh, gee.
Hit the rocks at 55. Transom's gone, but
that old boat anyway.
Well, I just kind of figured it was a wreck, and Mark asked if he could have it, so I just told him he could.
You're kidding me. What'd you want with that old thing?
You know what? I went out there the next day, I hooked onto her, hauled her home, and had a raffle.
A raffle?
A raffle. I sold 1,000 tickets at $5 a piece for a slightly less than 18-foot boat.
Jeez.
1,000 tickets at $5 a piece?
Yeah, look at this.
Did you bother telling him it was a wreck?
Well, I'm gonna tell the winner, but I'm giving him his $5 back.
Oh, that'll be all right.
Congratulations!
All right. Bought a ticket on your
Thanks.
Own boat, eh?
Sorry. Thanks, Barton.
Well, it's a darn good thing there's more to life than just fishing. There's hunting, too.
Yeah.
Nobody ever told me that big buck would come my way. Nobody will believe me how that monster got away. I thought I knew what woodsmen always do. I left my old truck, followed that buck. His trail was hot and I was too. I followed that buck into these pines.
mountains it started to snow. And I don't mind, but now the sun has gone down, it's dark and I'm just beginning to wish for light, a light. I never cared much for knee-deep snow, my compass is gone, so I don't know. Now I haven't a clue which way to go, I just wish I could see a light, a light. Maybe it's just not too smart to be wandering in the dark.
Wish I
had a match, then I could start me a four-alarm fire now,
right now.
I fired three shots into the air, but nobody came. They just don't care. Now I can't find my arrows anywhere. I'm beginning to pray for light, some light. As I sank into despair, I shot my one and only flare. It didn't stay up in the air. Now my pickup's on fire over there. There's a glow in the trees, it's clear to me that I just blew my warranty.
Approaching me,
I think I see, it can't be, coming to look for me, I'm beginning to see my light pass by, my eyes, run for your life, it's the
Yeah, sure, you know, you got to go deer hunting. It's every fall at Ole and his pal Sven, they got to go deer hunting. And one year they was up in the Keweenaw. You know, pretty rough country up there in the Keweenaw, lots of high hills and old mine shafts and such as that. And they come across this one mine shaft, and it was the biggest hole they'd ever seen. And Ole wondered how deep it was, so he picked up a rock and he tossed it in there. And he never heard it hit. Yeah, figured what he needed was something a little bigger, so they picked up a bigger rock and they threw that in there. Never heard that hit neither. Well, they decided what they needed was something really big, so they went looking around, and sure enough, in some old mine and stuff was a big old railroad tie laying there. So they dragged that railroad tie over the edge of the pit and they threw that in there. And they was just waiting for something to happen when suddenly a goat came out of the bushes from right behind them, ran lickety-split right between them as fast as he could go, and dove head first into that hole. Well, they was just pondering what they'd seen when a farmer come walking by. He said, "Either you two fellers seen my goat?" They said, "What color was he?" Said, "Yeah, it's a gray goat." They said, "Yeah, we seen a gray goat. He come out of them bushes right back there, running lickety-split as fast as he could right between us, and he dove head first into that hole. And we ain't even heard him hit yet." Farmer thought for a minute, and he said, "Well, that couldn't have been my goat. Mine was tied with a rope to a great big old railroad tie around here somewhere."
Spend their life chasing money and fame. I'm a youmer and hunting is my middle name. Looking for a buck that stands big and strong with a rack I can hang on my living room wall. You hunt 16 years, what do you get? Another year older and not a buck yet. Game warden might get me, but don't you know I gotta get one buck before I'm ready to go. I saw one evening
the sand and down by the pines.
I picked up my spotlight and it started to shine. He was 6 feet tall and his eyes they glowed. I just stood and stared and said, bless my soul. He's got 16 points. What do you bet? He's the biggest buck anybody's ever seen yet. Game warden might get me, but don't you know, I gotta get that buck before I'm ready to go. I've been hunting every morning in the drizzling rain. My wife says I'm crazy hunting
night and day.
I had to quit my job so I could spend my time trying to get that buck that's always on my mind. He's got 16 points. What do you bet? I'll be hunting every woods from the Sioux to Marquette, scoping every sound and everything that moves, bringing anything home that's got horns and hooves. Last evening I was hunting with my big spotlight. That buck was standing in my beam and he was in my sights. But then he shook his head, I knew that something was wrong. Then a red light flashed and there he was gone. He had 16 points. What do you bet? I'll spend the next 90 days in the jail in Marquette.
They took my truck and spotlight, my gun and knife.
But how could I know what a moose looks like?
Dum, 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 dum.
Oh.
Oh, gosh, you know, I love going hunting with you guys and fishing and stuff, but, you know, we're kind of spread out now a bit, so we don't get to do it quite as much together, but, you know, I try to get out whenever I can. You know, I like to be out in the boat and just trolling along and maybe trying to catch a walleye or two and just sitting there, and between strikes, you're just enjoying being outside and nature and all that stuff. And or maybe it's the fall and it's that time of year when you find yourself down into that old cedar swamp and you're leaning up against one of them big old burnout stumps from 100 years ago. It's got moss growing on it and you're sitting there by this deer trail and you're just waiting for that next buck to come by. It's just a wonderful thing. It gives you time to again think about everything that's around you and what we're a part of and to recognize the beauties and the wonders of nature. And it's not long before we realize that we're all just part of a great circle of life.
And when I die, you can bury me 'neath the western sky on the lone prairie. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam. Do 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 do.
What is reincarnation? One day I asked my friend. My pal replied, it happens when your life comes to an end. They combs your hair and scrubs your neck and cleans your fingernails and puts you in a padded box away from life's travails. The box and you goes in a hole that's dug down in the ground, and then reincarnation starts when you're planted neath that mound. The clods melt down and so does the box and you that is inside. And then you're just beginning on your transformation ride. After a while, some grass will grow upon this rendered mound. And then one day, a tiny flower upon this grave is found. And say that day, a horse comes by and feeds upon that flower, which once was you and now becomes your vegetative bower. Well, The posy that the horse done ate with all his other feed makes muscle, fat, and bone, you see, essential to that steed. But there's a part that he can't use, and so it passes through. And then it lays upon the ground, this thing that once was you. And say I passes by and spies this thing upon the ground, and I wonders, and I ponders about this object I've found. And I gets to contemplating about life and death and such, and I comes away concluding, Slim, you ain't changed that much.
Hasn't this just been a joy? I'm glad you all had beer before we started singing. We're going to have to do that more often, I think, make that part of the program. Now, we want to thank everybody involved. We want to thank the chorus for inviting us over and to come on down and sing for you folks. And we're all so happy that you're all here to allow us to entertain you for a little while. And we hope you had a great time. We think you have. Thank you very much once again. Now, before we sing our last song, I do want to mention about that CD thing. That's true. We got them out there on the table. So yeah, and there's a gospel one out there too. That we play that one straight, don't we, Tracy? We just
we're scared of Latin.
Yeah, just those are straight songs. So yes, come see us afterwards. Love to see you. Before we sing our last song, I do feel that I need to leave you with a nugget. Just a bit of wisdom, possibly. You know that if you give a man a fish, yeah, he'll eat for a day. But ladies, if you teach a man to fish, you can get rid of him for the whole weekend.
Until my time runs out, I'm gonna fish, fish, fish until I die. They're gonna say, hey, what a guy. I'm gonna play with my flies.
Ain't gonna miss a spring trout season opening.
I'm gonna fish, fish, fish until I die.
Big ones lay low, I'll have to stay low. Is this my day, oh, for a fight?
Cast like the devil, try every angle.
And when he strikes, glory, hallelujah, dance on that fly. He's got no chance, gonna fry.
And when I
net that thing, you're gonna hear me sing.
I'm gonna fish, 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 fish until I die.
Thank you.
Let's hear it for the four-man Fishin' Tackle Choir.